Oh, you changed your name to Big Tony?
I don't know. What is it? No, you tell me.
You just called yourself Big Tony.
Yeah, you're Big Tony.
Oh, Big Tony.
That's right.
So we changed your name to Big Tony.
No, it can
Big
be Swiss Tony. I don't know, whatever.
You Swiss Tony?
Swiss
Tony.
Just, what, I don't know.
Okay,
what,
Swiss Tony.
What is it?
It's Swiss
I'm
Tony
confused.
Now.
I'm right. confused.
I like Swiss Tony.
I like all that right. too.
Swiss you gotta Tony. Go against Swiss Tony.
Swiss Tony can,
so I'm back!
You're...
Have you seen Power Rangers?
I've not seen Power Rangers. I've seen Get Out.
Ooh, that's I haven't seen it yet.
You haven't seen it yet?
That's one of the ones I wanted to see. Like, the opening day.
You need to see it. So, like, here's the thing. I don't watch horror movies. I don't enjoy horror movies, but that one was suspenseful. It was funny. It was good
writing.
And it wasn't like a horror movie. It was a good freaking suspense movie.
But the thing is, like,
movie.
The thing is, like, you don't know that is a horror movie.
It's a very well written horror movie, and it's more suspense and thriller.
Yes,
which I very enjoy.
Yes, and also the fact that, like, when I saw the preview, I was like, oh, this is something that tons of people can relate with, not just like black guy and white girl or black girl white guy. Like, it's anyone who's dating someone from any different ethnicity or different background. It's always interesting to go and meet their family just because you grew up in two different places.
Yeah, well, you learn so much about somebody that way.
Yeah, it was just very interesting to me that they used that kind of minute detail of that type of relationship and experience and made a movie about it, because I know it does resonate with so many different people, like, across the world.
It looks very Stepper too. Like, it's so...
Yeah, very robot, underground, witchy.
Yeah.
Well,
I gotta see it.
Like, it's very well written. I really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Okay. Great movie.
That'll be the next
one. We'll go see that, and you should go see Power Rangers.
Yeah.
I'll watch Power Rangers on a plane.
It's fair.
Power Rangers on a plane?
No. Or like at
home. In
the
theater.
Yeah. I don't know. Okay, I'll go see it at home. In the theater. In my home theater.
In your home theater. Okay.
I don't have a home theater, by the way.
Swiss Tony. Now, besides the Zelda on this week, you're just playing Zelda?
Yes, mm-hmm. I know. Yes. And then the next month, I think it's the 26th, Street Fighter comes out. Yes. Can't wait.
Have you downloaded any other games for it? I saw that they released a couple new ones.
It's a bunch of SNK games, which, like, I want them to release Windjammers, because that's an SNK game, but tell them what you found. The thing you told me about the hearts and the stamina.
I think it's in okay, here's me mispronouncing every name in the business. Hitano Village is the first one you need to go to and talk to the older lady.
Yeah. She's the one sitting there by the ball.
Yes, exactly. There is a statue. If you come in and you go down towards Fairy Lake, Fairy Pond, there is a statue that it's like a demon statue that takes your heart if you talk to it, and you talk to it again, and it gives it back for 100 rupees. You can buy. It's kind of a scam, but if you go there, you can exchange hearts for stamina vessels.
Oh.
So, like, you sell, you know, you can sell a heart to the statue, you get 100 rupees.
Sell stamina for more hearts?
No, what you do is, like, you, let's say you have 6 hearts, and you figure that's too much, I want 5 hearts, but I need more stamina. So you go there, you sell a heart for 100 rupees, and then you buy back a stamina vessel. So, like, that's how you essentially can exchange it. It will cost you rupees, but you can exchange. If you know, like, oh, I asked for a heart, but I really should have asked for a stamina vessel. So you can do that.
I found a recipe that'll add like 3 hearts.
I have
one. It'll add 3 hearts onto what you don't have.
Oh yeah. If you there's lots of those in Sora Village. If you catch the fish, a lot of them add like extra stuff. Same with the sneaky field greens.
Oh yeah.
They add 3 or 4. Okay, so you have the same problem. Like, so I need 3 hearts, right? Mm-hmm. And I have like 7 meals that give me 10. I'm like, no, can't do that. So I just eat like 3, like 7 apples.
I do the same thing.
Because I'm like, no, I can't waste that. But then, like, I get so much more anyway.
I'm in the middle of a battle, like, trying to figure out, okay, wait, should I? I've only got, like, I'm on my last heart, and I'm, like, sitting there trying to figure out what I want to eat, because I want to eat the meal that's, like, 10
exactly,
plus
exactly.
cold defense and heat defense, because
exactly.
I'm, like, I'm going to need that
problem.
Later.
That's the problem. Just cook the elixirs so they don't add hearts, just our elixirs, because if they, like, give you hearts and elixir, I'm like, no, I don't need the
See,
hearts.
See, the elixirs are the thing that confuse me the most. So, like, sometimes I nail the elixirs, and then sometimes I get that lump of food that, like, is, like, blurred because I do it wrong. So, like, I'll take monster parts, and I'll put like a bug in there and stuff, and then it's like you've got something that's unrecognizable.
We have to think of like, ooh, you get a new weapon, but I can't use that weapon because it needs
gotta,
to be dead.
You don't
so
want
then,
to break.
So yeah, you don't want it to break. So what do you do? You beat the freaking boss with the crappiest weapon you have because you don't want to use the other one.
Yep.
And then like, it's so funny. And then like you end up never using the good weapons. Like, right now I have the electro sword, I have the ice sword, and I have the fire sword.
The electro sword only hits for like 23 though.
Yeah, and so does the ice sword
ice
and the thing. But like, it's just like, I'm like, no, don't want to use it. Yeah. I want to use it.
Because like, I've got two swords that are like 48.
Yeah.
Ooh, I have a 50 sword.
I got it. I have never used 60 it from the strength trial in the shrine, you know, the strength trial where you fight the thing.
Yeah.
One of those swords was 60. So I was like, oh, I haven't used it once. So I'm just waiting.
I have the 50 sword, and I had that like for like, I got it like really early in the game, and yeah, I haven't used it since.
Have you guys fought the evil fairies, the ones that have the wands?
I hate those.
Yeah, the ones by the and stuff.
Yeah,
I hate them.
The ones by the freaky, the ones by the tower. I can't climb the freaking tower.
See, that's so as you're trying to climb and you have to move around while you do it, like they're still shooting you. So like I got hit like 3 times, and died. So I sat back where I was and just used like all my bomb arrows because I was just mad at that point. Finally climbed it. But yeah, again, that's where stamina helped because I have like almost 3 wheels of stamina.
No,
I climb anything.
So you could climb for days.
Yeah, with the climbing gear on, so you climb faster too.
I only have the climbing cap.
Ooh.
In fact, the rest of the climbing.
Ooh.
But like, so those.
I have those wands from killing those fairies, and they're like 5.
Exactly, I had one, but I wish I would have kept it so I can shoot back at those fairies.
It is actually like it takes 3 shots from that wand to kill anybody.
Oh yeah, it's great,
but it's only 5 because it's not a melee weapon.
We gotta wrap this one up.
All right.
Guys, that's up, up, down, down, abrupt ending. Make sure you check your boy out.
Oh man, Blanca. Blanca.
Xavier VHD. Follow Romy Rome on Twitter at
Mike Rome, WWE.
Follow Swiss Tony on Twitter at
WWE Cesaro.
Follow the channel, Instagram, and Twitter at Up Up Down Out Views. Like, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. But most importantly, make sure you always and forever keep it tight.
Tight. Mm.